Good morning, everybody. Today is the 21st of January and my birthday. And so I thought I'd vlog today. I took the day off from work so that I normally don't work when it's my birthday. I make sure that I'm on leave so that, you know, I don't have to deal with crap on my birthday. So it's 10 till 9 in the morning and I am planning to go to... Sorry for the noise. There's like, my street is so noisy. It's like the main thoroughfare here, and there's an intersection, and every car wants to rev before they move on. So, and as I was saying, anyway, so it's Tuesday today, and I took the day off. I plan to go to the huge Salvo stores in St. Peter's in Tempe next to the IKEA over there. And there are a few things that I want to get, and I'm giving myself today as a leeway. My husband Duncan has actually given me permission to spend $100 from his bank card as his gift to me. So I'm doing that today. And so, yeah. Having breakfast, these are sweet potato fries. While I'm actually having breakfast, I am browsing Pinterest for some outfit inspiration. I've got Emma Hill on there because I really like her style. It's very classy, it's very chic, and it's very comfortable, you know. I used to experiment a lot with trends and buy stuff that I never ended up wearing, which is why I got this huge clothing inventory, because really I have way too much. Granted that when I'm part of the low buy beauties community on Facebook that Style Apotheca had started. I'm gonna link the page in the description bar in case you guys are wanting to do that. And well, essentially low buy, you make your rules, and I am making an exception on this day because it is my birthday, and plus the money that I will be spending isn't my money. So I'm looking at her style, because like I said, I used to like follow trends and all that. I used to watch all of these videos on YouTube about what's the coming trend in the coming year. And yet I have found myself reaching for the same items of clothing all the time. And I think thrifting is both good and bad for me, because good because I'm helping keep the clothes out of the landfill. It's much more affordable. And it's usually like the styles that I actually go for. And I used to be like squeamish about buying secondhand, because like you don't know who owned it before, what's the story of the clothes, like what's the person, did they have like a skin disease or something? But you know, I'm not that squeamish anymore. Anyway. Now, but it's also bad because of the fact that it is much more affordable and much more accessible for me. I found that I hoarded a lot of stuff, and that was, I think, one of the biggest mistakes that I've made since discovering thrifting, is that I didn't consciously think about what I wanted to buy. I wasn't picky at all. I wasn't picky about what I wanted to buy, and I didn't understand what fabrics were about and stuff like that. So I still ended up buying a lot of things but not wearing them because the fabric was itchy, or it was too hot because it was like made of plastic, polyester, acrylic, whatever. And I'm like, okay. And as I delve deeper into the differences in fabric, whether they're biodegradable, how they are being created, what's the situation of the people who are making my clothes, and what kind of working conditions do they have, I've become more and more conscious about it. And while I still am not in a position to buy sustainable clothing from ethical brands, like I can't buy them new because they're just so much more expensive, I've been eyeing like Everlane for a while, but Everlane's got some issues that I don't even want to go into right now, but they've got some issues with their workforce. And so I've been eyeing some of this more sustainable and ethical brands, but it's just so much more expensive and I can't spend like $100 on jeans. And so that's how I discovered thrifting. And that's how I discovered that I actually want to do this and I can do this. And I think now I would say 50% of my wardrobe is thrifted or secondhand, bought either on eBay, on actual charity shops, or on the Facebook marketplace. Which was the first thing that I bought brand new since August? Because I started actually thrifting in August. I can't even remember what was the last brand new item that I bought. I mean, apart from underwear, but everything else has been secondhand. So yeah. Anyway, this is a very, very long intro. I'm going to finish my breakfast and I'm going to put on moisturizer and sunblock and probably eyebrows and see how it goes. And then I'm going to take you with me to this huge salvo store. Okay, so here's a quick OOTD. T-shirt is from Muji. It is 100% cotton. I've had it for 2, maybe 3 years. These cargo capri, I don't know what you call them. These are by Esprit, and I think, oh no, this is not by Esprit, this is by H&M logo, I think is what it's called, I believe so. But I've had this for like 10 years. I'm surprised it still doesn't have holes yet. Shoes are Birkenstocks. I've had them for 2 years. This is a thrifted Gucci messenger bag. I don't know what it is actually called. Wedding ring, engagement ring. This bracelet here was my dad's. When I went home to the Philippines, I got it from my mom. By Marc Jacobs watch, gifted to me by Duncan back in 2013. My birthday in 2013, yeah. Necklace is our customized D&M necklace from when we were in Qatar back in 2012. That was his gift to me back in 2012. And earrings are from my mom. Yeah. So there you go. Okay, so here we are at the Giant Salvos. and it's pretty busy in the parking spots. Even though it is a Tuesday, which is a work day, a regular work day, but it's pretty busy. Okay, so in the basket right now are 3 pairs of shoes. I don't know if I'm gonna get all of them, but I'm thinking about this navy loafer. So they look black, but upon close inspection, it's actually navy. And these are cute. And this.
So I think I'm sure about this too because I need them for work, but this one, I don't know. I also have these two dresses by Calvin Klein that I'm gonna try on, also both for work.
Okay, so I'm back home and this is my mess. What I ended up with. So I showed you that I tried on this dress. This is actually one size larger than what I normally wear. This is a size 12. This is by Q, which is a really good brand here in Australia. It's Australian made, so I'm very happy with that. I usually wear a size 10, but I have gained quite a bit of weight lately. So I now wear a size 12, although my size 10 still work for me, but in dresses I find that I am mostly I need to size up. So this one, and I looked at the material of this before I bought it because it felt like you know those jersey kind of material, like what the scuba divers wear almost. But when I looked at, if I can find the freaking tag, so here it is, and it is 98% cotton and 2% elastane. That's the outside part of it. The inside is 48% viscose. Oh, that's 48% polyester, that's not good, and 4% elastane, and the lining is 100% polyester. So this thing here is polyester. Okay, this one though, I'm pretty pleased with this. This is, I paid, how much did I pay for this thing? I believe it was $20. Yeah, this dress was $20, and a dress from Q would set me back about $100 or so. I'm actually going to try and look up how much something similar to this would have cost, and I'm going to put that in this on the screen. Now, this one is a Uniqlo dress. It's a size small, it says on here, but I tried it on. It's actually quite big, so I don't know. But I like this. This is 100% cotton. So that's also one of the reasons why I decided that I wanted to buy one. I do love the neutral shade of it. It's like an olive brown. So, and as you can see there, it's $12. So pretty chuffed with that. It's a nice like summer dress. It's still summer in Australia anyways. Then I have here, this is a, where is this from? I think this is also a Uniqlo shirt. This is $6, and it is medium. This one is, I believe, also 100% cotton. Or maybe not. Sorry, 76% viscose and 26% polyester. Oh, 24% polyester. I'm bad in math. It's still got all of like the buttons there. It's got really nice feel to it, and it's going to be work appropriate. So that's the other one. And this one is 100% silk. Yeah, Saba silk, size 10. I also tried this on. And the tag says 100% silk for the main. And the contrast is also 100% silk. Cold hand wash. Okay. So I've been looking for a nice silk shirt. And here we have it. So pretty chuffed with that. Now, so obviously they're all pretty much work appropriate. Like even this one can be work appropriate depending on how I style it, because it doesn't really show much skin anyway. And then I ended up with three pairs of shoes. I ended up still buying this guy here that I was having second thoughts about because I felt like this would go well with trousers, whether I'm wearing jeans on a casual day or like trousers for work. And as you can probably tell now that it's against a black item, it is like dark navy. So I love the contrasting stitch. It's got a little bit wear in it, but it's still quite good. There's a bit of scuffing on the heel area. This one in particular has quite a bit, but nothing that a little bit of polish and conditioning won't be able to fix. Okay. I'm not familiar with the brand. It's S. Bensoni, and it's made in Italy. That's what made me want to buy it, because it's like real leather. It's made in Italy. So there was no way I was going to leave without it. This one was the second one that I found. It's by Karen Millen. It's from England. It's a size 37, which is my perfect size. I love how pointy it is. I love the hardware. I love the color. And the heel is not that high. It's actually quite comfortable heel. And because of the location, I've got some shoes where the heel is like straight up there. And I've learned from watching all of these YouTube videos about walking in heels that those aren't very sturdy. This one actually is right under the heel, so it gives you a lot more balance. So makes it easier to actually walk in. This again is leather. This is made in Spain. Even the sole is leather. I think this one says the same thing as well, but probably in Italian. Original shoes made in Italy. I don't know what the Italian words say. If anyone is watching is Italian, please let me know. And then this one, I was looking for nude shoes, and I thought that this were cute. Again, the heel is at the very base of the shoe. This is a little bit too tight on me. I reckon this is a 36.5. I can't see anywhere where the size is. Again, this is real leather. I might have to take off this white sticker on it, unless somebody can tell me what that says. It looks like it's Italian as well. Okay, that's weird. It actually says it's a size 35, which is shocking to me because it actually fits me. Like I said, it's a little tight, but I think that if I put, like I wear socks and wear it around for a few days, it would still expand. And because it's leather, it actually molds to your feet. But I think somebody has tried to do that, because if you can see the stitching on here, it looks like it's been heavily stretched. Okay, now I'm gonna try. This was the Karen Millen one was $20. This was $8, and this is $10, as it says so here at the bottom of the shoe. Yep. Now, because I bought three pairs of shoes, and these are all work appropriate shoes, I am letting go of these shoes. Okay. Those two boots there, that one is Dazzy and this one is Public Desire. I love them. I love their pointedness. I love how they look, but I don't love how they make my feet feel. They are really, really high. I mean, I can, because they're block, they're a little bit comfortable, but not comfortable enough for me to walk in the whole day. I mean, I could stand in it for an hour maximum. That's it. So I'm letting those two go. I was actually thinking about keeping this because I don't really have a light colored pair of shoes, and these are just really gorgeous. But if I'm being honest, when I was working in an office before, I had these underneath my desk so I can change into them when I wanted to look, you know, polished. But they sat there for a long time without being worn, because it's just not, I don't reach for it because they're so, there's one, the heel is quite heavy, and two, it's quite high. There isn't any platform in there to make it more comfortable. So I haven't really worn it, and I was thinking, oh, but the fall is coming. But I never really wear these light colored shoes during the fall or the winter, because
I wear like black thermal leggings and they just don't suit. So those are getting donated. I'm actually going to bring them to a place called Swap where you do you can exchange your clothes. Not really a clothing exchange, but more so they buy it off you. If you want cash, you get 25% off the value that they are going to be able to sell it. If you want store credit, it's going to be 50% off however much they intend to sell it. I'm also participating in a clothing swap via Instagram, and I am swapping this Doc Martens poly T-bar in blue suede, as well as this other Doc Martens Blair sandals in powder blue. Hopefully somebody would like them and would be their size and swap them for something else, because I've got too many shoes and I've only ever worn these two once. So after I did all that going around the racks and everything, I did notice something as I was trying on the clothes, and you would have noticed that I didn't buy that white Prada blouse that I tried on, because I actually found myself gravitating towards that just because it was Prada, because of the brand. But when I tried it on, it was pretty obvious that it wasn't a good fit for me. It made me look sloppy. The sleeves were quite short. I just didn't understand what that was. It kind of looked like, because I saw another one, there was another Prada blouse, also white, and that one had like a closed collar with a sort of like a cutout on the chest that was way too low to be office appropriate. But anyway, it kind of looked like they were like uniforms for the sales assistants or sales associates in Prada. But yeah, I kind of like gravitated towards it, and I was like, oh, I want to buy this because it's Prada. It was only $10. But when I tried it on, it just didn't fit well. It didn't make me feel good about myself. It didn't make me feel like it didn't make me feel beautiful. And the it was quite sheer, so I knew that I was going to need to wear something underneath that. So I'm like, I don't think it's a very practical choice of clothing. And to be honest, if it didn't have the Prada brand, I would not have even looked at it. So that's when I decided, like, I'm gonna drop this, because I think I'm buying this because of the brand, not because it's beautiful, not because it makes me feel good. And yeah, like now I'm trying to think of that when I look at, say, shoes or any kind of clothing. Do I want it because it's functional, it's practical, and I would get a lot of wear out of it? Or is my old self coming back and wanting to buy this item because it has a label on it, because it's got a brand name? If I took away that brand name, would I still like it? So that's the new thing that I have learned today as I was going through all those racks of clothes.